Part 1 will cover algorithm, feedback, oscillator. We will start with algorithm. Press the edit button, then press button 7 to see its algorithm used. The famous DX7 E.Piano 1 uses algorithm 5 like the tube bells patch. Yes, again, it's a divide and conquer approach, and I will explain this in detail later. We are moving to feedback. Press button A to see the amount of feedback applied to operator 6. In the FM synthesis, feedback is used for generating a sound packed with higher harmonics, such as a sawtooth wave, without the need for many operators. Its level is set to 6, which is quite high. We can use operator on-off buttons to hear what harmonic contents each tower is producing. Let's listen to tower 1 by turning on operators 1 and 2 only. It produces the main metallic tone of electric piano. Let's listen to tower 2 by turning on operators 3 and 4 only. It produces a soft sustained tone of the electric piano. Let's listen to tower 3 by turning on operators 5 and 6 only. It produces a sawtooth sustained tone of the electric piano. Let's look at oscillator. Press buttons 18 to 20 and use operator select to see each operator. By looking at this table, we can clearly see that the main metallic tone is generated by tower 1. Its operators 2 has frequency ratio of 14.00 to generate that famous metallic tone. For tower 2, ratios for operators 3 and 4 are set at 1.00. This is how the soft sustained tone is generated. For tower 3, ratios for operators 5 and 6 are set at 1.00. With feedback at 6, tower 3 generates the sawtooth sustained tone. We will look into detune. General rules of detuning to get a chorusing effect is to have two independent towers with similar or the same harmonic contents. In tower 3, operator 5 is set at minus 7, and operator 6 is set at plus 7. Although both operators 3 and 4 are set to 0, tower 2 is detuned with tower 3, giving the unique sustained tone with a chorusing effect. For tower 1, carrier operator 1 is set at plus 3. This means that you have three carriers operators 1, 3, and 5 with detune of plus 3, 0, and minus 7. Operator 1 is basically used as smoothing the overall chorusing effect. So, we can summarize what we've learned so far. Tower 1 produces the main metallic tone, and its operator 1 is smoothing out the overall chorusing effect. Tower 2 produces the soft sustain tone with a chorusing effect. Tower 3 produces a sharper sustain tone with a chorusing effect. We can pause here to do self-learning tutorials. Turn on operators 1 and 2 only. Select operator 2 and change its ratio up and down. How do these changes affect the main metallic tone of the famous electric piano? Put the operator 2 ratio back to 14.00. Turn operators 3, 4, 5, and 6 only. Select operator 6 and change its ratio up and down. How do these changes affect the overall tone? Put operator 6 ratio back to 1.00. Change the tune of operator 6 for plus 7 to minus 7 by 1 increment. What will happen to the overall chorusing effect? Let's revise what we've learned so far. The famous DX7 electric piano uses algorithm 5, which has 3 independent towers. Tower 1 used for producing the main metallic tone. Tower 2 and 3 are detuned to give a chorusing effect. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so yet. For the next tutorial, we will cover the sound design, electric piano, part 2.